God alone knows who is listening. Me myself, as I'm coming here, I'm teaching. It's only God who knows what's the motivation of teaching. Does it make sense? Now, that's why when we go to the marketplace, people are preaching. They are robbing themselves at time when they put an offering bowl. They are where somebody says the ones who go through fire, right?
Yes.
I think Corinthians chapter 3, somewhere there. It said, where should go through fire? Now, it said something, it said, concerning giving. It said, when you make it public, you have received what? Your reward. Because as you make it public, the reward is wow, 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 what a man, what a woman. The wow. That's why most of us who stand before people, most of us who are in the frontline ministry, we may serve God and lose the reward. Now, for instance, the person who arranged the chair, she can be in the church 2 years without nobody telling you, God bless you. Do you know that? But it's easy for somebody who lead the worship after it grows and buy egg for the person, buy cake for the person, buy what have you been buying? Say, challenge, today they're challenge, your son they're challenge, Namishra or buy. Hey, we are here, oh, we are here. But the person who sweep, because the person, when you were sweeping, you were not there. When the person was claiming you were not there, those people, they are wise who follow them and honor them more than some of us who are open before you. The secret prayers you pray, the intercession. Yeah.
So can we say deeds are judged and works are rewarded?
The two of them go to judgment, but the timings are, isn't it? Now, for instance, with words, let me use the Pharisees again. With the words of the laws, until you are caught, you have not seen. Okay. The Levitical law say when you catch a thief, you should pay 5 times or 4 times. So if they didn't catch me, I'm gone. But in the days, that is the New Testament, you don't need anybody to catch you. The police is in your heart and in your mind. Oh, Lord, Fafito Ajubili. You know, you stole, you know, the Holy Spirit will hold you on. You can argue with him. The more you argue with him, he will keep quiet. And you continue on life. But remember, at the end of your life, you will revisit it. If you accept his burden for you to change, then you repent. Now that repentance, something bring it to you. Then it said the Spirit of God will convict all men of sins. And now to convict it from sin, there's a certain judgment who does not lead you to contamination but bring it to repentance. Maybe one day we'll do it. When we say judgment, judgment itself is not condemnation. Judging is to know good from bad. Why are you judging me? Why are you judging me? We are just presenting to you the right way. But when we present it to you, when time is against you, then you, what follows it, follows it. Because, but when you are alive, they will reveal it to you. You can change because you are still alive. When they arrested the woman that was caught in adultery, they were reading the laws. the words of the law that this must be done. And they were ready to punish the woman. The stones were in their hand. And if they stone the woman, they have not sinned. They say we caught her in the very ashes. But in this time, you don't need anybody to catch you. You catch yourself. I remember they told her the story. They said, in the days of JJ, you know, JJ would just go out with any car. And they say he was in a normal car, which is not a presidential car. And they said, driver driving, he was at the bar. And they got to a barrier, and the policeman would tell him, you know, the way they want to harass you. And they were doing the thing. The driver was telling them, we're not giving you anything. And finally, they rolled the glass down. When the policeman saw that he was the president, he said, yes, sir, I fire myself. So, he said, you don't bother to say anything. I fire myself. There's a police in you. God should be firing yourself. You don't need for somebody to catch you. Now with the words make her to be hypocrite. Because words now, you can use words to satisfy your pastor if it's not spiritual. You tie your hair, wear the thing, you are not wearing those jeans, those dresses anymore. So the pastor who's in this level, wow, this is my church member. This man, Mary Magdalene. But he doesn't know what goes under the long garment you are wearing. So God said, well, you shall know them by their peace. That's the fruit. He said, don't bother to be digging the ground to be looking for the roots. When you see the fruit, you know what to call the tree. When you test the fruit, where a mango tree? This is orange tree. So he said, you shall know them by their fruit. Their deeds. Now to observe and to check this, it takes a lot of time and patience. Yeah.
So I have a question, I'm a little bit confused.
Yo.
Please, I want to know if these, because as
we are talking, these words can go through fire, you'll be saved. Then I want to know, is your...
Please, where am I smiling?
Pull effect.
If I saw my me and you are Asana, Wasana.
It's what then if your words.
You are giving microphone for people, you are not buying now. Why do you do this one? Why is my feeling smile? I don't need to teach.
Wow.
Okay, go on, sister. Not your fault.
Please, I want to know, because these words, it's like I'm guessing that sometimes your words is the one that is rewarding you. So if words, these are the things rewarding you, then what is taking you to heaven? Because if your words, you can do something good and you go to heaven and your word go through fire, the words will spoil. If you didn't do it well, like as you're living.
Do you know that even get me that scripture in Corinthians? They say some their words will be burned away, mm-hmm. and they will be saved.
So
now, for instance, you do evangelism. You can do evangelism to just have a name among them. You have their name. But as long as you keep your chastity, your holiness standard with God, your entrance to the heaven is sure. But reward that word should give to you, you don't have it. That's why some pastors they didn't go and take any juju, but they became worldly. When I say worldly pride should be against them, but the thing become their personal desire. The motivation was not God anymore. Oh, if this girl, she can preach. So the motivation is this girl can preach. And they say, you love souls. That doesn't make sense to you. Now, when it's like that, normally those your words should reward you, should get you things in God. Faithful is he that has called us. The Bible says, he that comes to the Lord must know and believe that is faithful. Is the rewarder of them. Diligently seek it. God reward. Okay? Now, rewarding and your relationship to enter to heaven are two separable things. Okay. You are in Ghana, so who are Ghana here? So leave Ghana now, we are suffering. Let me use America.
Yeah.
Let's say you're an American. Being a citizen of America, there are things that come to you. If you don't know them, you can't have them. You are in the nation. If you don't know and go for them, do not be knocking on the door, okay, take it. If you know, you must claim them. Why do we do evangelism first? It's a commandment. It's your relationship. It must be your relationship tied with God before any other thing. But people leave their relationship things with God, that souls must be won to heaven. And they became men, they have name among men. Like, the thing become, oh, okay, she's preaching everywhere. She's doing the thing bad. The main influence and the main purpose, that is God. The person cancel it away.
So does it make you hypocrite?
It may not make you hypocrite, but it make you unwise.
And would unwise make it to heaven?
You may. And that's what I'm saying, that some people, they know, they keep their relationship entrance or entry to heaven. That is, it's not lying. But which good example I'll give.
But what about people who just work, but you know, they are just ignorant about their deeds? Like, if you ask them to be doing so, but they themselves, they don't know why they're doing it. They only obey because
you know, working for God is so deceptive. Like, I sing, I preach, I play keyboard, I play drum. There are rewards on those things. Till you connect it to your relationship work with God, you do all those things. At the end, when they are rewarding people like you, they will not call you and you'll be shocked. Why? You didn't plug into relationship. You only do it. Okay. If we know God is watching out for something, how are we going to do it? We'll do it well. Because we know that He's watching it. Now, I'm using evangelism because that's the best way I can use. There's somebody in Ghana. He was also doing evangelism. I met him before. He told me, Philip, those your evangelism have been watching you. So I realized that, fine, the work is not for me alone, okay? But some time ago, I told the brothers, I told the pastor, I said, this guy, he not be serious. When I say he not be serious, like, I didn't be trending, he want to trend down to save souls. So the person is preaching truth, but he's preaching something that must change. So you must shock him with a certain ways. So the thing is not coming from the fruit of the spirit anymore. It's coming from the flesh. Why are you a human? But there's no reward for you because there's no, your work will go through fire because God wants quality, not quantity. He will sieve the work. We cannot just say that, oh, as a support, we are doing well just because we are all over doing mission. All that we are doing, if it's not in the details, in the level, in the standard of God, we roam all the world for nothing. If just for people to see that we also are doing evangelism, we are into mission, yes, we are most miserable like any other person. Then the chorister, the prayer leader, the teacher, the pastor, whoever stand and have opportunity before people must remember that there's a God that requires judgment and things will be rewarded. When we say reward, hear me, reward is not necessary for good. You can be rewarded badly. Revelation says, oh, I come quickly. Say, my reward is with me to reward whosoever according to what? Well, let's look for it. Revelation 1. You see, my reward is with me. Is it not 16? Oh. Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that comes. No, that one is.
22 verse 7.
Read.
Say, behold. No.
Revelation.
And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me.
Revelation 22, 4?
12.
Yeah, Revelation 22, 12.
And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give to every man.
To give to everyone according to his works. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Blessed are those who do his commandment, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter through the gate into the city. They say, my reward is with me. So rewarding you, you know, somebody that go to hell is also his reward. The Bible says, if that sow to the flesh, you reap. If you sow to the spirit, you reap the spirit. So when we say reward, it's not only positive thing. You can be rewarded. The Bible says God can never be mocked. That whatsoever man soweth, so shall he reap.
Wages of sin is death.
Right?
The wages of sin.
The wages of sins, that is the reward or the salary of sin is what? Death.
So before that scripture, it says something.
Mm-hmm. He said, he that is unjust, can let him be unjustly. He who is filthy, let him be filthy still. He who is righteous, let him be righteous still. He who is holy, let him be holy still. Amen.
So he's rewarding. He doesn't want anybody to be an outcast. So he doesn't know what to give him. So he said, okay, if you are holy, be holy. If you are holy, be dead. Because he's going to give to everybody according to their works. Now, Dorcas. What Dorcas was doing in the church, what was she doing? Was it this or works? Something said what?
This.
Yeah, let's define it.
What is in her that has come out? Because as we are talking, we realize that your personality is, but your works will define you. Your personality. So I believe
it's
what is.
According to Matthew chapter 5, blessed are the. Okay, let's go. Matthew chapter 5, verse 2. Then he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Four, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Five, comforted, thank you. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Six, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Seven, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Eight, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Nine, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Ten, blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. 11, blessed are you when they revile and persecute you, and say all kinds of evil against you falsely, for my sake. 12, rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for so they persecuted the prophets who went before you. Amen. Now, I beg all of you, if you want to have a modest life, you want your deeds to be well sieved, consider those words Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, what we call the Beatitude. These are Jesus' own words. You know, the verse 8 said, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. So simple but powerful. You can fulfill works with a wrong heart. Somebody can tie their hair, wear the long dress. That's works. If your holiness does not become inside and outside, you aren't going anywhere. Have I spoke American? You get me? Now, we have to be careful. The issues all of us are having now is the heart issue. Because the outside holiness, a lot of you are not fornicating anymore. You are not masturbating. You are not a homosexual. I was hearing a pastor who say, he just making, trying something in the church, say, who is a homosexual here? Let's pray for you. He was shocked. And somebody raised his hand. He said, he just playing in the church, say, if you're a homosexual, come and let me pray. He was shocked that there was a homosexual guy. Some of you are not homosexual, you are not. The women there. Lesbian. No, they have some name, baby. Lesbian. Lesbobo. Can you imagine? Do you dare hear? Who here is Lesbobo? Can you imagine? Lesbobo, your holiness. What shatare you, Nasu? Who here is Lesbobo? And say more. So, blessed are the pure in heart. This is what the issues are. But as of the unsolved works, a lot of people are showing it. You know, only your camera say you are preaching. Even the devil can do it. Even the devil quotes scriptures. He knows scriptures. When you go to Matthew chapter 4, he was talking to Jesus about scriptures. If thou say you are the Son of God, turn this stone to bread. He says, shall give his angel in charge of you. Your foot will not dash a stone. The devil can preach. The works are visible. The works you can see everywhere. I think Papa was telling me that some brothers we know who do evangelism, they gather themselves. They say evangelism, but it was just a competition among them. You know, when you go for evangelism, we have evangelical messages. Remember Lot's wife, John 3:16. Noah that can, you know, the 10 virgins. These are evangelical messages. Matthew chapter 24. How can I imagine? These people, they are giving mysteries. This one finished. This one passed the microphone. Can you imagine I'm doing evangelism sounding like I'm singing? In the name of Jesus, say yeah. Receive the power. I feel good. But people are going to hell. You are singing for them. You must preach like John the Baptist. So as for the wives, you may have the things are packed. And that's what is happening to Christian, especially the charismatic churches. Our senior people, everybody wants to have an album. That's works. But they have no character. And you remember that our churches these days, we are into light decoration than what goes on in our heart, in our mind. I was watching a pastor in Nigeria. The way he came to the camera, you see his muscles. You see his face like they definitely drawing him. You see that. It's no more about Christ. They will tell you that they are, what do you call it, reputation. Get integrity, forget reputation. Reputation are things men be for yourself. Integrity comes through your walk with Christ. Your brokenness. I be the reputation. You have what reputation? Get integrity. And we are doing the things and we are losing it. I was sharing something to Mama today. Around 4 or 3 there, I came outside. I was looking to Mufra and said, those tailors.
Mufra,
Oh yeah. So I hear, so I couldn't catch up with him, so I was sitting. When I sat, God actually ambushed me. There were 5 boys from school. They passed. I raised my ear to hear, to say, hey, brah, 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 brah. This 5 guy, and you know the way the Holy Spirit talk to you? Pray to them, I said, pray to them. And they passed. As they passed, I'm on my phone. The first thing that came, the head is here. So you not pray to them. I said they are gone. They have been walking. You not call them in my mind. If I call them, they will come. When I say that, they want their stood and they are talking. I hold them and say, will I miss this opportunity? You know, one of the things that will help you to obey God, how you feel when you disobey. I said, boys, come. And they came like flies. They came. I said, are you born again? They watch me. Who is this one? I was born again. So one pick it up. And I was shocked how open they were. They were open to the discussion. I talked to them, what's your age? 13, 12. I think the elderly is 15. And what do you want to be? Pilot, engineer. Someone wants to be an American detective, something. And you see these children, the capacity of their, what they know. I say, do you have Bible? Say, all of them say, yeah. Do you read your Bible today? Yes. When? In school. I said, Bible should be read at home before you come to school. We talk, and finally I said, can I pray with you? Do you accept it? A lot of students are passing.
Yeah.
They accepted it. And I press, okay, I live here. anytime you want to check on me, check on me. One of them said tomorrow he will pass that. So I was telling Mama, I said, hey, then what happened to you? You are disobeying. I said, ah, this is how we are, human beings. That one, there's no camera on it. There's no TV3, CNN. It's now between you and God. He said, do it. And so they are students, they will not come. And when I remember how I would feel disobeying, I say, even though they move ahead, and God was so good, you know what is in my mind? He made them students, they were just chatting. When I called them, they were five, they all moved to come. You know what? Have the reward in mind. Paul said something, he had the reward in mind. He said, I ran the race and I finished it. Say, now I wait to be a crown. You know what? Can you imagine? The guy knows what he's receiving. Barbara, you don't know your salary. If the man died, do we say the man ends? And you go to the bank, what you should be receiving didn't come. You not go to your financial whatever. Say, how much you pay me? Abna, you know nobody's keep it from John Bibu, teacher Bibu, Pastor Sam, Nicholas. At time, we only believe about the class, the house, the marriages. It told Peter that on this earth you will receive. But after here, you also receive. God is a rewarder of those that diligently seek Him. This is not the time to pass light. This is not the time to fall. Accelerate. I remember some years ago I went to Abidjan and church, they gave me a topic, acceleration. They said it's their year of acceleration. I think this is the time to accelerate. Keep pulling the good thing. Keep pushing. Keep praying, keep doing evangelism. Please do it like you are the only one God has given it to. Don't forget the joy of serving Him. Catch somebody for Christ. Catch the person. You are catching the person. You are making sure that the person is serving the Lord. You are making sure that the person has become a child of God. So, Mr. John, as you carry them on your motor, you will be preaching. Can you imagine you carry somebody on the motor as you are riding them, and you roll brake, car. And the person says, it's nothing, though. I forgot. Auntie, did you give your life to Christ? You know the person bishop? Say, motto, which kind of motto rather is this one? If you know the reward, you will not postpone our obedience. Now, among us here, some of you sisters, brothers, what are your deeds? That if the Lord will call you to glory before us, or the Lord will move you to Macedonia, while we are in Jerusalem or Galilee, what are the thoughts we have of you? Your deeds. You'll be thinking of how you separate us. You'll be thinking of how you were angry, how you talking me out. What would be the memory we have of you? When I say onorisco onore, you may smile and laugh, but that brother have this, or works. We have seen him with that small car, which is not for him. from people's weddings, people's something. It's never tired of carrying. It can, if you like, it can carry everybody one and be going and come. When your name come, what do we retain or keep of you? Your works, your peace in the family. You know, normally when people die before, a lot of people begin to mention their deeds and their works. And they put those things selfishly because they know they are missing what they are receiving that they don't appreciate. Today is on the 9th of June. We are truly in the half of the year. Accelerate. Some of you are doing personal evangelism, go back to it. They don't broadcast it. Go back to it. We came back to Liberia, we just want to rest. We are not even resting. We are hitting the streets again. Those evangelists were me. Who hit it? There's a new place in Atomic Junction. Even I see people are who saw our speakers. Even if a car passes, the people will raise it. They'll hear it behind the car. Yes. Carrying the church back to the streets. Now the way we do it in Abidjan, one person will preach, and you think when this person finishes his end, no, you pass it. Another person carry it. Let's go back. You know, the street evangelism and the one-on-one, it keeps you away from secret sin. Because if you do that, what certain things you can't do. Keep you out of it. As we are here now, Tamale is still calling. There are two villages beyond again. They say, where are they? When are they coming? Now, some of you, the mission is it the travel? You know, a missionary is not a tourist. And a tourist is not a missionary. They have different purposes. A missionary is a hunter of souls. And a tourist is look at nice location and take pictures and enjoy the environment and go. Why is losing his own soul? And that's why a man got to consume. And John Wesley says something, he said, men love, I'm paraphrasing, love watching men that burn with fire. So what it does is that it keeps fire to itself and men come to me. When Liberia, when a guy, because of the government, went to their courtyard and set fire on himself, not for Christ, he bore, put petrol on himself. Because of salary. When people are going to hell, when people are vacillating, when people are turning away from Christ, throwing the towel, what is your concern? It's because we ourselves, we are drenched. Water has so much cover us up, that's why we don't feel anything anymore. Remember the Domain Market? What about the secondary schools? I don't know. You know that second school around Waye? What do you call it? Umu Waye.
Accra.
Accra. Accra. No, no, Accra. Those that me, when I couldn't even speak good English, I went there and said they should give me opportunity to preach. And when you go to the second school, you see the young guy. You know, the spirit. The spirit. What about the hospitals? This is when people are sick, they carry them to the community. People know that. But if you don't go there with the gospel, you see, when you have the passion, God will give the provision. And don't forget about your own soul. Don't think about other souls and lose your own. The reason why you are chasing somebody's soul is because your own is in the same place. Eh? About Felicia. The souls of men must not be lost, but we must keep our own as well. We must do the work of Him that has called us now that is day. For the time is coming that no one will work, and the time is close. This corona thing. My people say, Ede Kabile too. This corona thing is shocking. You are all here about the vaccine. So some people think they were wiser, they were more advanced. They want to take it till their phone is locked on their shoulder. Remember, the Bible says, without the mark, you cannot buy and sell. The mark, they will receive it well. You can tell me that the vaccine is not there. But when you are going to the shop, the gun, where do they put it on you?
Yeah, I
shut your eyes. You see, these are the shadows of the things coming. The big shop, when you go now, after they do that, they take the temperature, your forehead, or your hand. By the time it's the forehead and the hand, something coming. So, this space that we have, people, let's work. I wish I have like two radios in Accra, Ghana. Me bohase, me bohase. You go, I'm a full-time pastor. What should I do best? You just wake up and sit beside your wife, singing words. Look at us. We are not old men and old women. And this is not about competition about churches. If you like, let's erase overseas of God. Just call it Jesus followers or something, if you like. But for we to be accountable of the souls, we have to get into a certain basket called overseas of God. The souls. When will it become of any of our brothers and sisters? You carry your own money. You couldn't pay much. You just pay one day, get 2 hours in. Those your birthdays, some of you do, and go and eat in Shangri. Shangri doesn't exist anymore. That's old school. Give me the place, Sammy. Give me the place. Thank you. You can gather that money and go to any of the radio. If you like. So, Pastor, this is my birthday. I want to buy you airtime. Go and preach for me. and we say, oh, people of God, we bless you. We thank God for today. Today is the birthday of one of our sisters, overseas of God. We thank God for her. This is how she wants to celebrate God. And then the radio there. We finish. You give us some envelopes. Some do it for formalities. Now, when you paste a picture of you on Facebook, when you go back, what do you go back to look for? The view, the share, the like, the comment. We have become common. Can you imagine any 5 minutes, 8 minutes, you carry your phone straightly? How many? And when I was teaching this in Abidjan, Pastor Isaac, he gave one of the examples that was everything. He said, even other people who don't watch his statuses, he went to block them. Social media have destroyed good relationship and have even destroyed the church. In this time that Christians, when they are wrong, they go on social media and write. Those days, when you are wrong, you go and repent, you seek the face of God. These days, you can no more go on in the life of a believer by what you write. Claude was telling me that they were in a group in Togo that one of the singers was sick in the hospital. When they were giving him injection on his buttocks, he did phone for somebody. Claude, stop now.
It's one of my friend, colleague singer. He was sick and went to the hospital. So he gave his phone to one of, I don't know if it was the nurse or one of our friends follow him. When they were removing his trousers, they take picture. The way he lay down, they take picture. When they were injecting him, they take picture. And his buttocks, everything was shown in the pictures. I said, ah, are you sure? Are you serious, guys? So that's why it is.
We are in trouble. I'm praying to get time to teach about social media and the effect it's bringing to the body of Christ. When this your emotional prophecy came, I was on the social media. I saw my own church member who wrote, "Oh God, keep my place in you." I said, "Hey, good girl, you're a boy. Don't pray to my correct. Hey, my correct." It means that if Moses were to perish, we would go forward. When I saw it, I was so sad for her. So sad. Should be receiving message, Pastor, we are with you. You know, even the first prophet, when Netu started with them, you hear somebody, I stand with this one, by your own pastor, who established your faith. They were writing things. Our Moses has fallen. We will continue. Forward ever, backwards ever. Social media is shutting us away from the presence of God. It keeps law, it keeps issues which should be resolved. A second, it keeps it days and years strife. And I don't know how many people make it. So sad. So the birthday wishes. Now, I was telling them something. What happened? If somebody's birthday, let's say, tomorrow is 10, tomorrow will be 10. So if someone's birthday is 10 by 5, the person will take special pictures and spread it. You know what is that?
Announcement.
If you are wishing me, select
this one.
The love of my flesh. Coming for me, Barbara, let me use your accent. Now, coming for you are singing the church, you open your mouth, and they take your picture, and I have that picture, your birthday. I say, I'm wishing my daughter in the Lord happy, happy birthday. Say that, Pastor, if you wish me, why that picture? May we live for God alone. Let's kill the flesh. So that the spirit can use it. I want you to pray. That God help me to have good deeds. In the family I found myself in the church of God among Christians, help me. Yes, another touch of your hand. Yes, Jesus, help us. Oh God, help us. Nimakusa valere kusa. Give us power every hour to be true. There is a rest we must run. There will be three to be one. Give us power every hour to be true. Keep us true. Lord Jesus, keep us true. Keep us true. Lord Jesus, keep us true. There is a race we must run. There are victories to be won. Give us power every hour to be true. So Lord, help us to be true. David said, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Lord, keep us true. Keep us true. Lord, we know we are not living in normal days. Keep us true. We are in perilous time. Keep us true. Keep us true. As Paul said, I've kept the faith. I've fought the good fight of faith. He has kept the faith. Keep us true, God. Keep our homes, keep our children, keep our wife, husband, keep us true. Keep us true. Jesus, keep us true. Keep us true. Jesus, keep us true. May the Lord keep us true. For the days ahead are not good days. May the Lord keep us true. There are days of terrible happening. Who are ahead of the church, but the church is still sleeping. The church is still praying. May the Lord help us. May the Lord help you. Make it your personal prayer. Because a pastor will not be there. A brother, a sister will not be there. You got to be there alone. May the Lord keep us true. If there's something to do for the Lord, do it now. Tomorrow will be too late. If there's a sin to confess, do it now. Do it now. Do it now. You can hide it from man, but you cannot hide it from God. You cannot eat from the table of witches and wizards and come on the table of the Lord. Repent or perish. Help us, Lord. Lust in the mind, lust in the heart. Fleshly behaviors. Wickedness in secret places. The thoughts of men, the heart of men are evil. Oh Lord, help us. Help us to be count worthy. Help us to be wise virgins, not the foolish ones. Help us. Help us to have the truth as a belt. Help us to have the right place of righteousness. Help us with the sword of the Spirit, the helmet of salvation, the readiness of the shoe of winning souls. Help us. Let your fire again burn in us. As Jeremiah said, it's as fire locked into my bones. Help us. Oh, help us. Let intercessor receive power to intercede. Let the one that have the gift of liberality receive grace to release money for God's work. Let the teachers teach, let the prophet prophesy. Let the apostle plant their churches. Let the evangelist evangelize. Let the pastor pastor his church. Oh, Lord, help us. This is the time to be paid for the master's use. For the master's use. Oh, my sister, my brother, don't waste your existence on earth on useless things. On the perishable things of the world. The grounds are seeking grounds. Will your uncle hold in times of trouble? Oh, if I who say, may grace be imparted unto us that we stand firm and sure. Stand firm and sure that enough of compromising, enough of betraying the Christ, enough of denying him, enough. Masukeri Karosa, may our hearts be lifted up against that of the enemy. May our hearts be strong like that of the unicorn. May the Lord cause a revival into our gifting, into our spiritual life. We will do his will. Many are they that have lost it. Don't lose it also. Don't lose it to anything. What profited a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? How can you get the world against your own soul? What a tragedy unto your own soul. How can you get the world against your soul? The Bible says, all shall pass away. The world is passing. The world is passing. God, help us to stand. Help us to do your will. Help us to stretch ourselves to the limit you give us. Help us. Jesus. Yes, we will do it. Masos, yes. Say yes. Masos, say yes. Say yes to your will. My soul say yes, say yes, say yes. My soul say yes, say yes. My soul say yes,
say yes,
say yes,
say yes.
If Jesus has said, Father, let the cup go away permanently, what will have happened to salvation? The Bible says, how can we escape if you neglect your great salvation? There's something God is calling you for. There's something God is calling you for. You have done everything but not that one. Tonight, as you are going home, you are praying that God push me to it. Jonah was running away from it, but God pushed him to it. May the Lord push you to it. Somebody shout, God push me to it.
God push me to it.
God push me to it.
Push me to it.
Jonah was running away, but God pushed him to it. May the Lord push you to it. May the Spirit of God. I don't know what God is asking you to do. I don't know what mandate God has placed on you. I don't know what place God wants you to stand in. But tonight, as Jonah was pointed to the right place, may the Spirit of God carry you. Carry you, carry you to it. You will pray again in that room. You will give that offering again. You will preach that message again. You will do that fasting again. You will forgive again. It's never too late. You can forgive your husband. You can forgive your wife. It's never too late. You can do it. May the Lord push you to it. Christ. John was king of all, with a horse, he was ready to rule the whole world. He was ready. May the Lord push somebody to the will of God. That disappointment that caught you by sleep to do the will of God, let there be a rekindle, a revival to your personal revival life. Go back to your Bible. Go and study the word again. Go back. Go back to the secret place. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I'll say, of the Lord is my refuge, my fortress. Tonight, may the Lord push you to it. May the Lord push us to it. We will not only go to school and get a certificate, but we will have the cause of God also. We will stand to be counted among men that work for God. We will stand to be counted. Let the fire burn again on the altar of our hearts again. May we depart like a lion. We are not here for entertainment. We have not come to follow men and water. We are here for an assignment. You must fulfill destiny with the Lord. Let the Spirit of God tonight move us to it. The churches are empty. The markets are empty. The buses are empty. Where are the preachers? Souls are perishing. Lord, I will say. And we are only thinking about who asked. Who said what to you? Why you are called to win souls? Push me to it, Lord. Push me to it. Lead me to it. Move us to it. You cannot go to school enough not to have time to work for God. There's no certificate who can buy you away from the will of God. There's no school who can carry you away from the mandate of God. Paul was an apostle, but a lawyer. He worked for God as well. Peter have not attended a school like Paul. He was just a fisherman. But Peter has made his mark. Whatever way you fall, whether school or not, we can still work for God. Revival now. Father now. Whether you preach in English or in Tuareg, you must preach. You must preach. Any language that you can speak, that you don't preach in it, you should be touched by it. This is the time to go back to the older mark. Where are your prayers coming? Where have you removed your prayer coming? Where is your prayer coming? Where is your prayer coming? May the Lord push you to it. May the Lord move us to it. Many people have fallen to the net of witchcraft because you have not been praying. Because you are not doing the will of God. But tonight, power is coming on your head. Power is coming on your life. Tonight, the Spirit of God will ride with you. Tonight. Let flesh die. Let the Spirit take over. You think more of who should marry you than about your marriage with the Lamb. The Bible said, how? Hallelujah for the bride of the Lamb. For in she has prepared herself. How prepared are you? Man, how prepared are you? How prepared are you, girl? How prepared are you, pastor? How prepared are you? Give him what you want to have from him. What are you giving to him? After God gave Abraham, as a God as of Isaac, there's nothing that God can give you that you cannot give back to him. May you all return to the Lord. Upon Mount Gilboa, Saul died, and the Bible said by the mouth of his prophet David that Saul died as though he was never been anointed. greatness will be useful for my generation. My mandate will affect life.
Oh.
Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Papa, Joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river. Joy like a river. Joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river. Joy like a river. Joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul, joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul, joy like a river, oh, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Oh, joy like a river, oh, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, oh joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul, joy like a river, oh joy like a river, joy like a river in soul. I said joy like a river, oh joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul, joy like a river, my joy like a river, joy like a river. I said joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul, joy like a river, oh joy like a river, joy like a river. Joy. Joy like a river. Oh, joy like a river.
The city, the watchman, work but in vain.
It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrow. For so he giveth his beloved sleep. Lord, children are heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is reward. May the Lord reward anyone that made it. As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are the children of the youth. Happy is the man that hath his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemy at the gate. Lord, my heart is not haughty, nor my eye lofty. In that do I exercise myself in great matters. Psalm 131. Surely I have behaved and quiet myself as a child. That is when of his mother. My soul is even as when child. Let overseas of God, let Pastor Philip, my colleague. Let Israel hope in the Lord. Amen. And henceforth and forever.
Amen.
Let the saints say, amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you tonight. There's something unusual that God has given us as a church. Go and melt it in the house. Keep it. Let it translate to a revival. Go back to your post. Devour again. Let love lead you. Let joy be part of your service to the Lord. And determine that even if nobody wants to make heaven, you will make it.
Amen.
You will make it.
Amen.
Last Thursday on the path, the Lord has given me a word to give out. That was, God knows you are on earth. So, Kashibe. That means only better said, who are successful. So, it will take care of you.
Amen. Yeah.
The rent you pay.
Amen.
The food you have it.
Amen.
The best does not work, but God feed them. How much more you? The one that have created you is still alive. He knows you are not yet married. He knows he has promised you. And you are where he knows. So keep faith alive. Keep hope. Always and every day. Thank God that you are saved.
Amen.
We are the children of light.
Amen.
We are not ignorant of the devices of the enemy. So I leave grace and favor upon your life.
Amen.
I'm believing God for you that Sunday as we meet and congregate, even Friday you have a testimony.
Amen.
That which God alone gives, may you receive it. That which God alone give, and may we receive it.
Amen.
May the Lord be your way maker.
Amen.
May he be your head lifter.
Amen.
May the Lord establish you in good things. I pray as we learn about works and deeds, your deeds will glorify the Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Shalom. Amen.
Amen.
What do you say to our pastor?
God bless you.
Please say it louder.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
So we are praying for our parents and the Lord together, that the Lord sustains them.
Amen.
The Bible says, I lay me down and I'm awake. For the Lord sustains me. Begin to pray for them. Pray for them. Father, sustain them. In the name of Jesus, your sustenance, O Lord, in every good thing, in the name of Jesus. Father, sustain them, sustains them, in the name of Jesus. Exalt them, O Lord. The Bible said that he shall anoint you with fresh oil, and thy horn shall be exalted like that of a unicorn.
Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that cause their home to be exalted. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you because thou, O Lord, art their provision and their shelter. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, O Lord, that you enable them in divine health. Divine health. Divine health. In the name of the Lord Jesus. As it is written, as for those that are the ungodly, their teeth thou hast smitten out of their mouth. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you all. So you are praying for yourself again that, Lord, as I'm going home, keep me. Amen. Keep me. Everything that I have received tonight, Father, enable me to uphold it. In Jesus' name, begin to pray. Pray for yourself. Pray for yourself. Our brothers and sisters on the internet, need to pray for yourself that everything that we have received tonight, we will uphold it. In the name of Jesus Christ, that grace will be imparted. Grace will lift us up to walk before the Lord and be perfect. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord bless us.
Amen.
Amen. So please, some of us that are in church, when we close, we call them. Amen. Then remember that tomorrow we'll be meeting at the park in the evening at 6. 7. Okay, 7 to 8 or 9. Amen. And then Friday too, we'll be meeting here. Amen. Friday, 6 o'clock. Just start. So let us do what you can end. May the Lord bless you all. Amen. So God bless you. Let us share. Okay. Please, 1 minute. Can we pray for Pastor Francis? He's not well. Somebody pray for him. Pray. Lord, touch him. Lord, touch him. Touch him right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For healing. For healing. Father, watch over him and the family, the church in Akominya. Father, we also put your remembrance, the church in Liberia. Father, enable them. Enable them. The leaders over there, enable them. The church in Abidjan, Timbuktu, you put on. Father, we pray that you will touch them also. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So some of us, we should call him and encourage him. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercies are following us all the days of our lives. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.